All right, so let's go to the blackout, because the Aztecs were trailing 17-13, right? They were down by 4.
I am so disappointed.
In the waning minutes of this game, when the power went out, Nick, they had some momentum, and I thought this could screw them.
Yeah, it could go one way or the
other. I thought
this
could steal the win for them. Yeah.
It could certainly go one way or the other.
Now, they called timeout.
It's very interesting to hear how this was all going to go, because they're in the middle of that drive.
Right.
How deep were they into that drive before it happened? There was only, what, 3 or 4 plays after it, and I believe it was an 11.
They were 40-some yards out, I believe, when the power went out.
It was an 11-play, 75-yard drive.
I think Rashad Penny just had like a 36-yard run to put him into Stanford territory before the lights went off.
Yeah, and Rocky Long called a timeout because it seemed very obvious to allow Rashad to catch his breath. But then about 10 seconds later, the power went out, so they were somewhat robbed of a timeout, which they would have gotten anyways with the power outage. But it didn't matter because Rashad had way more time than they expected he would have, with 20-plus minutes to relax. And I thought that this actually, like, if you think about the old Bill Walsh days with the 49ers, Bill Walsh used to script like the first 30 plays. So if you have this much time, perhaps you have a chance to script
exactly three or four plays. Go in.
And it looked like that's what they did, because they executed to perfection.
Yeah. You get to come out, reset, have a good 5-6 plays drawn up, ready to go. You still got plenty of time left on the clock. 4-plus minutes to go. You want to hear Rocky Long on the blackout and how that affected their performance.
Didn't say anything to them. Told them they're going to come back on in 15 minutes and we better score a touchdown to win. I mean, what do you think we do? Go tell ghost stories?
Personally, I would love to hear Rocky Long tell a ghost story.
Maybe we'll request one. We've got time in the Rocky Long show.
Yeah. That's great.
Ghost stories.
Tell
me about Pecan Head. Dump, dump, drag. That was an old CYO story that I used to hear sitting around the campfire. Pecan Head. I was scared of a guy who had a head shaped like a pecan for years.
Pecan Head.
Pecan Head. Yeah, he had no legs and he drug himself around camps.
Oh, my gosh.
And killed little kids. That's what they told us at CYO. The night we were camping.
That's freaky.
That's good stuff, huh?
Very good stuff.
Scraby, I'm looking at the play-by-play. I do not see a Rashad Penny 36-yard run.
No.
That did not happen on the last drive.
Okay.
Sorry. 3-yard run, 3-yard run, 11-yard run, 6-yard run, 3-yard run, 2-yard run.
No 36-yard run?
But if you add those up, if you add them up together.
You're nearly half of 36, yes.
You know, David Shaw said this, and I thought that this was very fitting, because we talked about, all right, well, who else needs to have a big game? And Cameron Kelly was exceptional. I mean, there's a lot of praise to go around.
He looks legit, doesn't he?
But David Shaw said in post, he said, this is a really good football team. He said, I hope we didn't take them lightly, but I didn't do a good job of getting us ready to play a very good, very physical football team that not only runs the ball, but has a quarterback that can get out of the pocket and do a bunch of different things. So how about that, right? You had Christian Chapman, who apologized after the ASU game on Twitter for not playing well enough. We asked Rocky Long about that. Rocky said he actually had a pretty good game. But how about Christian Chapman saying, I'll be better, hashtag beat Stanford, and then David Shaw in the post game is not only praising the running game, but goes out of his way to praise the quarterback as well that made some big passes, including the game winner to David Wells.
Nearly 70% completion on the night. 21 for 29, 187 yards, had a QBR of 38.1, which, take what you want from a QBR. There's so many different ratings. The quarterback rating, just the old school rating. We're looking at a 38.1. What the hell do these mean? All I know is he completed 70% of his passes,
right,
and that's damn good.
And no INTs.
And one touchdown.
Yep.
The game winner. Clutch.